kind presentation here. And now I would like to invite our next presenter, Dr. Razik Kakar. At first, I would like to introduce him to all. Okay. Just a second. Okay. This is Professor Dr. Razik Kakar. He is an international livestock and camel consultant and technical operation manager, Camel Dairy Alliance of Abu Dhabi. He's from Abu Dhabi. And his research area or expertise areas are integrated livestock systems and agroecosystem farming, management and conservation of native animal genetic resources for food and agriculture, turning camel from a beast of burden into a sustainable farm animal, food security question under the climate change scenario, the mobile herds and pastoralism. He's actually a camel dairy professional. And now I'm stopped sharing my slide. Sir, Dr. Razik Kakar, sir, are you here?
No, he's trying to join. So maybe just give him a few minutes, or alternatively, please invite the previous faculties. They can start chatting, and in the meantime, he can join. So we'll quickly take him in.
Yes, sir. Sure. So, Christiana, madam, Ilse, madam, and
yes,
ma'am, you may continue. I interrupted you. Sorry for that.
Oh, I can talk. You want me?
Yes, up. You can talk. Okay, great. Up to who the next presenter present his lecture.
Okay, great. Well, it's kind of great that I'm actually, here with Dr. Razik, even if he's not able to connect, because we've been colleagues for years, and then I was able to go over and observe him, and I wrote about him and what he does in Camel Crazy, and he is just an amazing naturalist with a feel for animals, plants, trees, everything. He feels it deeply. And he is from Pakistan, and he is just one of those people that's attuned with nature. So it's just great to know people like that. I guess some of the other things that I could talk about real quickly, just to keep people up. There are many other health conditions that camel milk is used for: diabetes type 1 and 2, TB. It seems to have protective effects in the liver. It really helps with conditions to do with inflammation. So and that can work from the inside out. Crohn's and colitis patients find it useful. It also can help with skin conditions and things like that.
Dr. Razik has joined.
Okay, great. Okay, hi, my friend. I'll let you take over from here. Can we hear him?
Yes, we hear you.
But we can't hear Dr. Razik.
That's the problem.
Dr. Razik, please use your mic. Please use your mic.
Hello. Can you hear me now?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. Thank you very much for your patience. I am really sorry for this inconvenience because I am nowadays on vacation in very far-flung areas of Balochistan. So here was like a lot of rains. There was no power, electricity. So I'm sorry for that. I am here now. Please let me know when I can start my talk. I did not hear before anything.
Please start your lecture, sir. You may start.
Okay, thank you very much. I'm Dr. Razik. I think you people know me. I'm basically from a livestock keeping community, basically by birth, by tribe. I am from a nomadic family. So I did my graduation in animal science from University of Agriculture, Faisalabad. Then I did my MPhil PhD and work as professor in Pakistan. So nowadays I am working with the camel farm in United Arab Emirates. So my work is mainly on ecosystem management, food security under climate change context. These are my issues. So the main thing is my concept is to use the native genetic resources for food and agriculture as one of the most important source of food security under the prevailing climate change conditions. Like we see any climate change, before it was like the people were just thinking that these are like some hoax by the scientists. But climate change is now reality. We can see the fire hazard, the wildfires, the flooding, the droughts, the aridity. So in such conditions, the native livestock breeds which are evolved by the livestock keepers in the long history of evolution, and they are well adapted to the climatic conditions of its ecosystem. They can survive, they can sustain, and they can produce food for the livestock keepers and the local consumers. So my talk will mainly be I will emphasize on the role of such livestock breeds in climate change conditions, and these breeds, what are their important, how these people, the local people, the native people, how they care them, and how they have strong communication interaction with their animal genetic resources. So that is my main emphasis of my lecture will be on this issue, the role of the native genetic resources and the role of the native genetic resources keepers, I mean the custodian of the genes, and the ecosystem, and the question of food security in such challenging climatic conditions. Okay. Now, if we see my main topic will be in Balochistan. So if we see at the map or the ecological distribution or geography of the Balochistan, we will see that we have northern highlands, very cold regions, here is some vegetation, some rain, some snow, sustainable rangelands. Then we have the western desert area, which is called as Chagai Kharan, this region. And then we have a long coastal strip where there we have different livestock. And then we have central highlands of Balochistan. There we have different livestock breeds. So then we have a plain land and the hottest area of the region, like Sibi and Dadar, this area. So we have mainly five climatic zones. There we have different livestock. They are well adapted to the local ecosystem, and they are very promising livestock genes, livestock genetics they produce in the conditions where other livestock, if we import from other countries, from especially like now there is trend, the people import the livestock from the developed countries like Holstein Friesian and the others. So these local livestock, they can survive and sustain very better. We have the roots in the northern highlands of Balochistan. Here we have camels, we have sheep, we have goat, we have chicken, we have donkeys, we have horses, so we have cattle, the six, seven species we have. So camel, we have mountainous camel, which we call Kohi camel. mostly they have white color, some they are brown color or fawn color. So camel of our area. I did my PhD study on the camel in this region, the Kohi camel of mountain. The average was 10.22 lichen in camel. Those people who know our listeners, they know about the camel. So this related to the mountainous ecosystem, is the animal of the desert. But it is not true. We have seen, yani we are living with the camels. They are living in the mountainous region, and they rely on the bushes which are found in the mountains, like Kiragena in Bugua and other. So that is number one. Then we have cattle, the very famous cattle of this region. We have the oldest cattle civilization. The cattle has very different name in different regions, but the species, the breed is the same. Some area they are called in Afghanistan, the same cattle is called Watani. In Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, it is called Achai. In Balochistan, in our area, it is called Kohe Suleimani, or it is also called Lohani. That is almost the same cattle, which is producing less volume of milk, maybe 2 to 3 liters per day. But the milk is very has very special taste, very special flavor, and there is very high consumer demand locally. And these cattle, here are some bushes which we call in local language, it is from grass family, which we call sargassai. If the cattle will not eat, other livestock cannot consume that bush very well. So they are actually the guarantee for the fertility of our ecosystem. So the cattle is very important in the areas where the people replaced the local cattle with the crossbred Holstein Friesian. The overall fertility of the land decreased of that region. So that is very important local culture. Even 3-4 thousand years before, our currency was in cattle. 2 years mature male bull of our cattle was the currency, which was called pasa. Or nowadays, like in India, Rajasthan, they call pasu. In Punjab, they say pasu. So this was pasa. The pasa is the, and now change the word into paisa. You can see like the 100 paisa make 1 rupee. In Pakistan and even in India. So that is cattle. Then we have sheep. Our area is the part and parcel of the ancient Arya Varsha. Arya Varsha means the grassland. The grassland, also this region was called Murga. Murga means the one very famous grass, Cinchrus ciliaris, which is one of the main food of sheep and cattle. So this area is like we have in Balochistan, we have in our Pashtun area, even in Baloch area, we have different tribes of people. Some are sheep tribes, some are goat tribes, some are camel tribes, some are mobile tribes. They only have chicken, but they go with they put their luggage on donkeys, and they collect the seed of some herbs and they sell the herbs. They are like local healers for animals, for human, for both. So the sheep, we have very rich sheep culture. We make, we process the sheep milk, which is, we make curd with the sheep milk, which is called posa, with the seed of Vitania cogolon. Vitania cogolon is locally available, abundantly available herb which have some enzymes which coagulate the milk. Okay, so we have one study in United Arab Emirates. we use the vitania seed to coagulate or the to make cheese or cut from the camel milk. So already our paper published on this topic. So then we have goat. We have famously we have Khurasani goat. This area is like we were part and parcel of Khurasan, and this area is like the main the one of the main and the ancient culture, animal culture of Khurasan. So the our goat is mountainous goat, and it is called Khurasani goat. This goat has long black hair, and when I was kid, we were using the hair for making the tents and for making the ropes. Even now, the nomads, those who travel with their livestock, they use the goat hair for the making the ropes and making the tents. This goat is very good in milk. She produce milk in very challenging conditions when there is like no rains, no greenery on the plain lands. She can go up and up in the mountain and can bring some milk in her teat for the keepers. So that is the about the. So we discussed the sheep. We have the camel and the cattle. Then we have. We have two kinds or two types of donkeys, which we call, there are two types of donkey. The donkey is very important animal in this region, both used in agricultural farming, also used for carting in the cities, in the peri-urban areas, used as a carting and luggage animal in the agricultural farming, used for the nomadic migration. We have like for long travel, we have different donkeys. They are long neck. The long neck breed of donkey, they call it, is in Pashto, we call it Shingari. So they are used for long travel. The people who cross the borders, they go into Afghanistan, central highlands of Afghanistan, and in summer they reach up to Punjab, southern Punjab. They used such type of donkey. And but the main breeding area is this region where we live and where we belong to, yani, where our livestock community is surviving or living. The other type is used very locally. They are very strong donkeys, but they are small in size. Such donkey is mainly used for water fetching. The people, especially the women, they use this donkey to bring water for their families. They are called sparkai. Sparkai mean like poor or polite. Polite is more better word. So this is our donkey. Then we have the very famous Baluchi horse. Baluchi horse is found in very wide region, and it is one of the most important horse breed of Pakistan, not only in this region but in Pakistan. They are smaller in size, but they have very compact body. They are equally good for mountains, for plain lands. Even in the desert area, the people use these horses, which is called as Baluchi horse. So this these are equine breeds. We have like two types of donkeys. I will share the pictures, everything. I'm really sorry. I am far away from my main system. Believe me, I charged my mobile. I send it to the city and charge it in someone's shop. Because in village here was like, because yesterday here was very erratic rainfall. So everything is like seized. I'm sorry for that. Next time I will share the pictures, the video, the everything. So the equine, I told you about the equines, about the sheep, about the goat, about the camels. So now we will come again to, if there is time, please guide me. I would like to have some details of each breed. Like for camel, we have two types among the Kohi breed. One is foal, which is brown. The other is white, which is white Kohi. So the people mainly, they use the camel for breeding to produce male. The male are bought by the nomads, or those who travel with their livestock to Afghanistan. The male are also bought by the people, the carters in Punjab, those who use these camels for their carts. Nowadays, there is high demand for such camel, especially for the white camel. The people like their beauty. Some people, they keep it like a pet animal at their home. And even some camels, they have very good export value. So there is very high demand for the white camel, and the number is increasing for this camel type. Almost 3% annual growth in population is noticed of this breed. So this camel has milk. Locally, the agrarian people in some areas, they use this breed for milk because the people you like the taste of the milk, little bit saltiest, because they browse on salty bushes like Heloxylon mostly, and the people like the taste. There is very high consumer demand. And the other breed, we have another breed also, which is half found in Afghanistan, half in Balochistan, Pakistan, which is called Regai. Regai mean that one is found in the sandy area, like in the sandy area, which is very good on browsing on the local bushes, and they can tolerate high salt contents, and they rely on saltish water. In that area, sweet water that is close to our area, but in that area, the sweet water is not abundantly available. So the water which is fetched from the wells has a saltiest taste, and the other livestock does not like the taste, but the camel is happy to drink that camel. That camel is called Regai. Regal. So then it's used mainly for transportation by the nomads. That is also in that ecosystem which I am talking about. But now there is agriculture farming. There is very high level of water harvest from the groundwater, and there is issues. The agriculture is going down, but the people are again coming to the livestock. Livestock is one of the main sure source of income. So that is about the camel. The sheep, the meat of the sheep is highly preferred in our area. The people dry the meat of the sheep in for winter use, and they use the dried meat of the sheep for the whole winter, because here the winters are longer and very harsh winters with snowfall, and sometimes the mercury drop up to minus 10. So that is the sheep is the rich source of energy for food in our area, not only for protein, but for energy, because the meat has very high percentage of fats, and the people prefer to consume fat. So that is about the sheep. The goat, the goat milk is mainly used for making the sour milk, which is called, here we call it Shilombe, but in subcontinent, this is very famous with the name of Lassi. So usually the sheep and the goat milk is mixed and used for making Lassi, and the Lassi is filtered. The Shilombe is filtered, and dry hard ball, you can see hard cheese, is produced, which is used by the people. They crush it and use it with the butter oil and put it on the bread. And this is one of the very famous cuisine of our region. So I don't know so how long I can continue my speech. So please let guide me, Ilza. You are there,
sir. You have 5 more minutes. Please continue, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. So the goat is like the goat milk is also has is mainly liked by the people for sour milk making sour milk. The sheep milk has more fat content, so we make the butter the which is called butter oil, which is called ghee. We mainly produce by the sheep milk. So that is the specially to make it dry and use in winter, number one. And the other, the sheep milk is very good because it has very high fat contents. The people make ghee or butter oil from the sheep milk. Also, we use the our sheep wool is carpet quality. So the wool is used for the rugs. Locally, the people can the people make the rugs at home, at village level. And some people, they have like some advanced structure and they make carpets from the sheep wool. So the sheep is used for meat, for wool, for milk. Goat is used for hair, for skin, and for meat and for milk. The skin of sheep is also used locally, and we also send it to the tanneries, which is found in other part of Pakistan, like Punjab. There are tanneries. We don't have any tanneries over here. And the sheep and the not only the market value, just to sell something and to buy something. The sheep are one of the most important player of the ecosystem. Management, because the sheep, the goats are otherwise useless. They are very far in the far-flung areas. They are in high mountainous areas. They are just like very woody or very rough bushes. Otherwise, they are waste. But these animals, they eat them. They convert them. Into nutrients. And they can actually the food for the detritivores. Yani, detritivores are those bacteria, fungi, algae, things which convert the manure into compost. And such compost is on other hand provide nutrient to the local bushes. So they in the areas here where in the areas where they restricted the goat grazing. We have the weeds, which is not controlled by any weedicide. They are just occupying the land. We have now weeds which are deteriorating or distracting the fertility and the crop production of the land. So the animals are not just important for to produce food. They are the very important player of the ecosystem. These animals, if are allowed in the the forest in is here. If they are allowed, livestock grazing is allowed in the forest. The fire hazard will be decreased because they will cut the link between the trees and the shrubs. Because the shrubs and the grasses, when they dry up and the weather is very hot, there is 100% chance of fire. So the livestock is the grazing livestock, the natural livestock, the people's livestock. It is not only for food. It is the most important player of the ecosystem management. It is the most important player of the soil fertility. It is the most important player of because mini seeds, when you take it from the tree and put it in the ground, they will not germinate. When they pass through the GIT, through the intestinal tract of the livestock, then they can germinate. So the livestock is actually the biotic player, the very important biotic just for our food, just for our return, just for money. It is more than the food. It is more than the economy. It is more than the money. And also these livestock is part and parcel of our culture, of our heritage. So it is the part of the culture. And this is the part of our cuisine, because we do not eat, we don't like the taste of the meat of other regions. We don't like the taste of the milk of other regions. We have our own processing system for each product. Even by smell, we can tell that this butter aisle is from such, from that species, that is from that species, and from that tribe, and from that tribe. So that is the livestock is the very important layer of the part and parcel of our culture, of our identity, of our ecosystem. So therefore, we ask that the policymakers, they should not look at livestock only for producing food, only for generating money. It is the important part and parcel of our heritage, of our culture, of our ecosystem management, of composting the foliage into rich soil fertility, into providing food for the detritivores, which are we cannot see, like the small worms, the insects, the things which are living on the earth. They eat from the livestock manure. So livestock is our all emphasis should go to convince the livestock policy makers to please not look the livestock just on their production, but we should look the livestock at broader in broader concept, like role in ecosystem management and our livestock, such livestock, grazing livestock. This we called low carbon livestock, because they move, they walk, they eat, and they digest very efficiently the fiber. They are not producing the methane with the same proportion as the methane is produced by the high-five Holstein-Friesian cow farm, dairy farm. There they eat like concentrate, they are static, they stay on one place, and you can see a lot of dirt, a lot of smell. But here the livestock, they just are the part and parcel of the natural ecosystem. Thank you very much. I hope you understood my talk. I am really sorry. I have no presentation. I have no pictures, no video. So thank you very much. So I am happy if there is any question, any thing, I will be very happy to reply, to answer.
Thank you, sir. Though he could not show any slide, but your speak tells everything. It was very wonderful session, a wonderful presentation. You told about the five climatic zones that increase the livestock genes and make diversified livestock. And you mentioned the varieties of livestock there. That was very interesting. And you already have seen in the chat box that most of the people want to see those varieties. That was amazing. And you told about the different tribes of people, the camel tribes, goat tribes, different tribes of people. And you also very clearly mentioned about what kind of variety is popular for which purpose. You mentioned about the specification of the varieties, and that was great. And you also told about how livestock helped to reduce forest fire and ecosystem, and how the ecosystem, how they manage the ecosystem and increase the soil fertility. I think that was amazing. That was amazing. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your presentation. Nice presentation.
Thank you very much. You are welcome. You are welcome.
Okay.